In this illustration, we'll discuss on various spectral lines from a hydrogen-like atom. Here we are given that a gas of hydrogen-like atoms has some atoms in lowest energy level A and some in the particular upper energy level B. And there are no atoms in any other energy levels. And it is saying the atoms of gas gets excited to higher energy levels by absorbing monochromatic light of photons of 2.7 electron volts. And subsequently, during de-excitation, these atoms emit radiations of only 6 spectral lines in the spectrum. And these are different spectral lines. So, 6 types of energies are emitted from the gas. And it is also given that some of these are of 2.7, some have less, and some have more than 2.7 electron volt. Here we are required to find the quantum number of energy level B and ionization energy of these atoms. So, in this situation here we can see, in solution we can first write that 6 spectral lines are total emitted. So, we can write if atoms are excited to nth level, this implies we can write NC2, which is n multiplied by n minus 1 by 2 should be equals to 6, which gives us the value of n is equals to 4. That means finally the atoms are excited to n equals to 4 level. Here we can draw the energy level diagram also. If this n equals to 1, this n equals to 2, here is n equals to 3, and if we consider this as n equals to 4. And we can consider some atoms are in the lowest energy level A, so this A, and finally the atoms are excited to 4. So obviously the difference of energies between either A to 4 or B to 4 should be 2.7 electron volt when the electrons are excited. So, B has to be either 2 or 3, either this or this would be the possible state B. Now, in this situation, when electron will de-excite from n equals to 4, the possible energies are corresponding to 4 to 3, 4 to 2, and 4 to 1, and then other will be 3 to 2, 3 to 1, and then it will be 2 to 1. So, these are the 6 possible energies which could be emitted. And we are given that some have energy 2.7. That means one of these would be 2.7. And few would be more than 2.7 and less than 2.7 also. And carefully you can see this is the only possible energy corresponding to which higher and lower both energies are available for n equals to 4. So, this energy would be corresponding to the photon of 2.7 electron volt. Here we can say as difference of energies of B and 4 is 2.7 electron volt, and in de-excitation produced photons are of energies 2.7 eV, more than 2.7 eV, as well as less than 2.7 eV are there. This implies we can directly state that energy level B will be for n is equals to 2. Because if it is n equals to 2, then 4 to 2 will be corresponding to 2.7 electron volt, and less than this as well as more than this both energies are available over here. So, here we can write 2.7 should be equals to ionization energy of the gas, which is actually 13.6 zeta square multiplied by 1 by 2 square minus 1 by 4 square. And this ionization energy multiplied by 1 by 4 minus 1 by 16. Here, in this situation, ionization energy, we cannot directly write as 13.6 Z square, because 13.6, a constant we consider for a simple atom in which 13.6 is the binding energy of a hydrogen atom. Now, in this situation, if we calculate the value of ionization energy, you can see this gives us 2.7 multiplied by 16 divided by 3, which is 14.4 electron volt. That is the result of this problem. Here, one thing which is important to understand, that is, if you calculate the value of Z, it won't come out to be an integer, because it may be possible that in such a situation, the value of constants for the ionization of a hydrogen atom may not be 13.6 if we account the mass of nucleus, or any such situation in which the value of 13.6, in which mass of electron is being used, it could have taken a different value.